Okay, so this time we've got Alma and the Butterfly, and this book is written by David McKee. Alma, the patchwork elephant, was out walking when a shout came from up a tree. "Hello, Alma. Is that you, monkey?" Alma called back. "No, it's me," laughed Cousin Wilbur from behind a bush. "Hello, Wilbur," chuckled Alma. "You are clever with your voice tricks. I'm going for a walk. See you later." Not long after that, another voice called. "Help, help," Alma smiled and said. "All right, Wilbur, come on out," the voice called out again. "Help, I'm trapped," Alma laughed. "If that's you, Wilbur," but before he could finish his sentence, it was Butterfly, trapped in a hole behind a fallen branch. "Poor Butterfly," said Alma, and he lifted the branch to release her. "Thank you, Alma. The branch fell while I was in the hole," said Butterfly. "Perhaps one day I'll be able to repay you." "Don't even think about it, Butterfly," said Alma. "If you do need me, just call my name," said Butterfly. "Wherever I am, I shall hear you." A butterfly saving an elephant. That's a good one, chuckled Alma as he continued his walk. At that point, a narrow path led off the main one. "Never been here before," he said. "This looks interesting." The path suddenly led out of the trees and along a cliff, face high above the valley below. "This is dangerous," said Alma, "and the path goes to a cave. I'll go back." "Oh dear, going backwards here isn't easy. I'll go to the cave, turn around and walk back normally." Alma was nearly there when the path started falling. He rushed into the cave and peeked out. Part of the path had gone. "Oh no, there's no way back," he said. "Help," he shouted. There was no answer. "Help," Alma called again. Still no answer. "They're all too far away," he thought. "I'll try Butterfly." "Butterfly, help," he called. He was about to try again when Butterfly arrived. "Oh, Butterfly, thank goodness," said Alma. "Now it's me who's trapped in a hole." "Don't worry, Alma," said Butterfly. "I'll get help." Wilbur was amusing a group of elephants when Butterfly arrived. She quickly told them about Alma. In no time, the elephants were rushing to the rescue. At the cliff top, the elephants saw how dangerous it was and most kept away from the edge. Wilbur disappeared back among the trees. One or two elephants carefully peeped over the edge to try and spot Alma. "I see his trunk," said one. Wilbur soon came hurrying back, pulling a very long, strong creeper. He threw one end over the edge of the cliff and called down, "Catch hold, Alma! Tie the creeper around you and hold on tightly," said Butterfly. "Don't worry, it'll be all right." Alma tied the creeper firmly and called out, "I'm ready!" The elephants caught hold of the creeper and pulled. Alma swung out from the cave and then upwards. Once he was safe, Alma thanked them all, especially Butterfly. "Fancy a butterfly saving an elephant," he said. Then a shout came from the cave. "Don't forget me!" The elephants stared. "Who else is there?" said one. "Just Wilbur's voice," laughed Alma. "Let's tickle him," but Wilbur was already running home. The